Good morning everyone, this is Akhand from fundamental team of Axis Securities. Today we have come out with an initiating coverage report on Technocraft Industries. Technocraft Industries operates in four segments: drum closure, scaffolding and formwork, textile and yarn, and engineering and power segment. Now coming on the first segment, which is drum closure. Technocraft Industries is the second largest manufacturer of steel drum closures and continue to enjoy a worldwide market share of 36% in drum closures. It's a cash cow business for the company with ROCE of 80%. Barrel drums are considered to be used for single use, as multiple use can lead to chemical reaction and can affect the quality of the products. So there is recurring demand for drums. We expect a 8% growth in drum closure business, mainly driven by demand from pharmaceutical, chemical, lubricant, oil companies and hazardous industries. There are entry barriers in the drum closure business. Drum closure manufacturing requires a high level of precision engineering to prevent leakages, which acts as an entry barrier for small players. Drum closures is a mature market with relatively small market size, deters large players from entering into this space, which acts in the favor of Technocraft Industries. China is one of the growing market for drum closures. Technocraft is focusing on China for drum closures and has set up manufacturing capacity there. Technocraft Chinese operations posted revenue of 90 crore and had a profit of 3 crore in FY15. Size of drum closure industry is around 50 million sets. So we can say that there is requirement of around 100 million sets of drum closure, wherein each set consists of four different parts to complete a drum closure and to be used by the drum industry. The company has manufacturing capacity of 40 million sets per annum. The product range include flanges, plugs, gasket and lever latches. Now coming on the second segment of the business, which is scaffolding and formwork. Scaffolding is a temporary structure modular system of metal pipes or tubes. Technocraft Scaffolding division consists of more than 200 components and everything is manufactured in-house by the company. Scaffolding comprises of scaffolding, formwork and tower business. Its major revenue accrue from overseas market. Scaffolding business has grown at a CAGR of 29% over FY13 to 15. And has achieved a revenue of 319 crore in FY15. Currently, it is generating ROCE of 17%. We expect a growth of around 20% over FY15 to 18E on account of demand from US, Australia and Europe. Technocraft is largest exporter of scaffolding from India. Different countries have different standard and certifications for quality of scaffoldings, which acts as an entry barrier in the field of scaffolding business. Currently, North American, South American and Australian markets contribute 60%, 20% and 15% of scaffolding revenues respectively. Technocraft is increasing its market share in South American market by expanding aggressively in the larger Latin American markets of Brazil, Argentina and Venezuela. Now coming on the third segment, which is textile and yarn segment. Company's 28% capital is employed in textile and yarn segment, which is generating 22% of overall revenues of the company. Now coming on the fourth segment, which is engineering division. On account of acquisition of Swift Engineering, a Canada-based EPCM company, the revenue of engineering division has increased from 18 crore in FY13 to 85 crore in FY15, while its earnings increased from 1.9 crore in FY13 to 5.4 crore in FY15. We expect a CAGR of 10% over FY15 to 18E from engineering segment. Now coming on the valuation part of the company. Now first segment, which is drum closure business. Considering 80% ROCE and around 8% annual growth of drum closure business, we have valued this segment at 5 times FY18E earnings. And second, which is scaffolding and formwork business, which is growing at a rate of 20% with ROCE of 17%, we have valued that segment at a PE of 7 times FY18E earnings. We have valued other business of the company at price to book value. And sum of total parts of the company comes at rupees 250 per share. Based on SOTP valuation, we arrive at a target price of 250 rupees per share, which provides upside of 25% from current level. Thus, we initiate coverage on Technocraft Industries with a buy rating. So this is from my side. Thank you.